The works all donated ranged from some with particular relevance to the Pitt's dispute, this one was sketched by the wife of a striker, to those with a less obvious theme. The auction was billed as a gesture of solidarity with miners by artists, the GLC maintaining their role was simply to provide the space. But they were bidding and soon became involved in a battle for the only Hockney on view, sold to the ratepayers for £520.
Well, capitalists tend to buy works of art for a hedge against inflation. And I think ratepayers' money can be justified, the expenditure can be justified in the same way.
And I suppose it doesn't hurt that it's in a good cause, as you'd say.
Well, it pleases me no end, quite frankly, that we've bought a David Hockney and the proceeds of that go to the miners. I mean, our stance on the miners is one of 100% support. So on both elements, we're absolutely delighted.
The miners' union were delighted with this latest way of raising funds.
People tend to forget that this has been the longest dispute in the mine history, in the history of Britain. And apart from our members having hardship, the wives and the children suffered the brunt of the hardship. And the government and the NCB are using our children as a stick to drive the fathers back to work. And it's as cruel and cynical as that.
Nearly £8,000 was raised in all. That'll go to the NUM Solidarity Fund to help out the families of striking miners. Paul Lousman at County Hall for Thames News.
£480 then.